स्टूडेंट इन टूडेज लेक्चर अगेन वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग विद और वी आर स्टार्टिंग विद द न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 3 कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट्स इन पाइथन. बेसिकली द कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट्स विच वी हैव सीन इन C++ लैंग्वेज द सेम टाइप ऑफ कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट आर ऑल्सो देयर इन पाइथन बट द सिंटैक्स इज डिफरेंट. मीन्स देयर आर सम न्यू कीवर्ड्स विच यू आर गोइंग टू सी इन कंडीशनल स्टेटमेंट टॉपिक ऑफ पाइथन. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द लेक्चर. First conditional statement is if statement. Normally in other languages we use curly brackets to write down the condition. After that we are having curly brackets to specify if the condition is true or which statements you are going to execute, right? But in case of if statement of Python we never write condition within round brackets. After writing if keyword we simply write the condition. And after condition we will put colon. So that is a syntax for simple if statement of Python or if statement of Python. We use colon in Python. So basically whenever you want to execute a statement if a specific condition is true, in that situation we use simple if statement. Normally simple if statement is used whenever we are having only single condition to check, and if that particular condition is true then we are having set of statement or a single statement to execute, and after execution of that statement the part which is present outside of a if that will get executed. Here the important thing is indentation. As I told you that we don't have curly brackets in Python, right? So which statements are inside if condition and which statements are outside if condition, that will be recognized with the help of indentation. So this is unique point in case of Python, that is without indentation your program is not going to get executed. So indentation is important. Indentation means if you have written just see the syntax which is in blue, yellow color. I have written if keyword, then put space. After space write down the conditions, that is a greater than b, a equal to b, whatever condition you want to write with the help of conditional operators. After that put colon. So colon is a part of syntax. After colon press enter, and after pressing the enter press tab, because tab space is important. And actually in case of Python, if we are using the Python software, we don't need to give a tab manually. It will be automatically generated by the interpreter of Python software. So after tab, whatever statements are present after if condition, that will be considered as a part of if. And if you notice that in syntax, hash further statement is if necessary. This statement is started just below the if. It's not, its indentation is not below the statement keyword. It is below the if, means it is indented with the if, means that part is present outside of the loop. And the indented statement, that is two times I have written statement, before statement there is a space, there is a tab, right? So it means that these both statements are part of if block. And once you left that indentation, if you start writing the code exactly below the if keyword, or the indentation of that particular code is if exactly below the if condition, then it is considered as out of if statement. So this is your simple if statement. I have given the example within square bracket. First person is a variable in which we are taking the nationality of the person from the user. So to take the input from the user in Python we use input function. So input into round bracket within double quotes nationality question mark. So within double quotes we specify the text which we want to display on that input box, and whatever value we entered in input box that will be saved as a value for person variable. Then I have written condition as if person equal to French, means if the nationality of a person is French then simply I want to print hello message. If it is not, then simply we want to print the bye message. So for this logic I have written this code. I hope you have understood. First we have taken nationality from the user, store that value inside person variable, then we have written condition as we want the person's nationality to be French. So for that I have written the condition, if person double equal to within double quotes French then colon, then I want to print hello. And by the statement with the by text is exactly below if alignment. So it means the print by statement is outside if loop, if condition. So output will be, first it will ask you nationality, then suppose the user have entered French, then the message will be hello and bye. In this example, we have written small French, and as a input I have entered French with the capital F, so only bye message will get displayed. There is some printing mistake, actually typing mistake by me. It is small f only for French, so we will get hello and bye as a message. One more example I have given, that is A equal to 33, B equal to 200. Then I have checked if B greater than A, that is 200 greater than A, our condition is true, then print B is greater than A. So if you are writing statement like this, you will get error message. Why? Because if you want to display the message as B greater than A, then that particular print should be indented inside if, means there should be a tab space before writing the print statement. So you will get, this is called syntax error. Indentation is very important. Without indentation you will not be able to execute program in Python. Just remember this point, it is very 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 important. After that I have given shorthand if, that is in a single line also we can write the if statement like this: if A greater than B colon print A is greater than B. Means in previous example we have written if B greater than A colon, then we place or we click on entered button, that is our statement is on new line, right? But in shorthand if you just have to write down the statement on a single line only, that is if A is greater than B, the A is greater than B, this message will get displayed if the condition is true depending upon the values of A and B. So that is called a shorthand if, that it means we can write if along with its statement on a single line. So this is your simple if statement. Whenever you have only single condition is condition to check, and if that particular condition is true, then you want to display something. So in that situation, you will make use of simple if statement. After that, we are having second type, that is if elif statement. Now here we have else also. If else statement is there, but other than else keyword, we are having new keyword, that is elif, which is used only in Python. So if dot dot elif statement, it will work similar to if else statement only, but we have else also in Python. So I have given the syntax, that is if you have written the, you will write the condition, if the condition is true, then the statements which are inside or indented within if will get executed. And elif statement, along with elif also we can use condition. We have seen else if statement. When we write else if statement, we write the condition. So elif is similar to else if only. Okay, so elif, then we will write the condition. Means if one condition is false, first condition is true, you have statement. If first condition is false and again you have one more condition to check, so in that situation you will use if elif statement. And the further code, means if the condition is true, the statements which are indented under if will get executed. And if the condition is false, then the condition which we have written along with elif keyword, that will get executed, that will get checked. If that condition is true, then the statements which are indented inside elif block will get executed. And if both the conditions which we have written in if and elif are false, then the part or the statements which we have written outside if elif statement, that will get executed. So again I have given the example, we have taken A equal to 33 and B equal to 33. Then we have written first condition as if B greater than A, so 33 greater than A, the condition will be false. It is not greater than equal to. If it is greater than equal to, then the first condition is going to be true. But in this case, if B greater than A, that is 33 greater than A, is false, so our program will jump to elif. In elif, the condition is A equal to B, that is 33 equal to 33, the condition is true, right? So what will be the output of this particular program? A and B are equal. This you will get as an output. After that, next program I have given, as I told you previously, that is we are having else statement also. So when we will use else statement along with if elif statement, suppose if you have written more than one condition, if you have written one condition in if, one condition along with elif, and if both the conditions are false and you want to display something, so that part you can include inside else. If both the condition which are written along with if and along with elif keyword are wrong, then the else part statement will get executed. So for that purpose I have given the next example. A equal to 200 we have initialized, B equal to 33. Then we have checked if B greater than A, that is 33 greater than A, condition is false. So if part the statements which are under if block are not going to execute. After that we are having elif statement. A equal to B, that is 200 equal to 33, again this condition is false. So the statement which was present inside else block will get executed. Actually it is not visible for me also, but there is a statement. So in the second example, what will be the output? The statement which is present inside else statement. You will get to see the statement which is present inside else in your PDF file. So just see that. After that again we are continuing with the if elif part only. We can have else statement without elif only. Previously we have seen if elif. After that we have taken second example, in that we have seen if elif else. And now it's not compulsory to write elif statement. Without elif also we can execute the program. So that is it. It is like normal if else which we have seen in other programming languages. So first example I have given that only. A equal to 200, B equal to 33. Then our condition is B greater than A, that is 33 greater than 200, condition is false. So if part is not going to execute, which part will get executed? That is the statement which is present inside else block. So you will get output as B is not greater than A. This will be your output for the first program. As we have seen shorthand if statement, similarly we are having shorthand if else statement also. So that example I have given. Again this is a unique, or this is new thing which is added in Python. Elif we are not having in any programming languages. Similarly we cannot write a shorthand if operator. Yes, we can write actually shorthand if else operator, but for that purpose we need to make use of a ternary operator, that is question mark colon. So without using that question mark colon also we can write the program in Python only. So the just see the shorthand if else program. A equal to 2 we have initialized, then we have B equal to 330, then print A. When the A will get display if A greater than B, and if this condition is not true, A greater than B, then after the condition we have written else print B. So print B will be printed. So this is shorthand if else statement. So in our program what will be the output? We are having A equal to 2, B equal to 330. So A greater than B, that is 2 greater than 330, the condition is false. So the output is B. B will be displayed because of this statement. I hope you have understood. Print A means first we have to write down the statement which we want to display when the condition is true. Then we will write the condition with if. And after condition, if that particular condition is false, then which statement we want to display, that we will write after else keyword. So that is called shorthand if else. These things are not there in your set publication book or other books. This material I have downloaded, collected from different websites, so that you should have a clear idea about each and every small topic in Python. This is a reason I have included this. If you want, you can check also. That is, do we have shorthand if else statement in your textbooks? And this is, I feel that you should know each and every part of Python. After that we are having ternary if statement. Ternary means we can say that now here we have written shorthand if else. So ternary if else, it is similar to the if elif else statement which we have seen. that is if we are having condition, elif we are having condition. If both the condition of if elif are false, then the part which is present inside else will get executed. So same that if elif else statement we can write with the help of ternary if statement. So ternary means with the help of ternary if statement we can execute more than we are having three statement to be print according to the conditions.